Hi guys, thank you for joining me. Here's an update what's going on at Yellowstone Super Volcano. There's been a lot of talk about Steamboat Geyser. No, its activity really has not spiked lately. Its last eruption was 6 hours and 18 minutes ago. And that's as of when I was making this video. Before that, its last eruption was 11 days, 13 hours. Before that, 14 days. 17 days, 65 days, 37 days, etc. It has erupted 17 times so far this year, not beating its record of 29 eruptions, last year, the year before? I believe it was the year before. The last eruption evidently wasn't witnessed when the log was put in, but they went by the discharge volume that came out of Tantalus Creek. Now for the eruption that occurred on October 13th, this is holy whatever, right here for the start, just decided to walk over, shortest wait ever. Started with concrete miners, minor eruptions, that instantly grew and grew and grew to start. She was a dirty girl early in the eruption, a vanilla swirl, very tall, 1,255 steam. Cysteine dropped to just at overflow at 45 minutes. So that was a good eruption. In the last week, USGS has 22 eruptions. The last one was today, a 2.0. They listed it as Wyoming at 329, a magnitude 2.1, 4.8 kilometers in depth. So that would be 2.98, almost 3 miles below sea level. All earthquakes are measured from sea level. They also have a 1.7 posted for today. Same location. So I have four spectrograms, four monitors here. This one is the borehole 207. That's for the Madison River area. This monitor here is not a borehole, but it's for Norris Geyser Basin. The next one to the right is Little West Thumb, and then we got Lake Butte. This has got the best signature, so I'll open this one up larger for you. And we'll go to its signature. There it is. And there's been other earthquakes. They're only reporting one more for today. But you can see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11... and 12, 13 marked in red. Now that means the computer picked it up, sends a message to the geologist there at the University of Utah, and maybe the scientist in charge, Michael Poland, and they're supposed to review these earthquakes. So here we have the borehole for Madison River, and here's the earthquake as it came in there. And there's its spectrogram. Let's see if it really was a magnitude 2.1. And it was. It was actually a 2.13. I'll bring it down so you can see it there. It's at the bottom. It says MD 2.13. So they reported a 1.7 at 232, but it actually came in at 225, 1.7. And there's the spectrogram for that earthquake. It actually was a magnitude 2.16. So they lied about that one. And then we got another one that they're not reporting at 209. There's its signature and the spectrogram. We'll go back to the signature. That comes in as a magnitude 2.15. And then we got another one that they're not reporting. I'll make that one bigger for you. 232. Oh, okay. That's the 1.7. So they did not report this one at 225. And 232. That's the one. It's supposed to be the 1.7. There's the spectrogram. Yeah, we'll go back to this one here. This one they're not reporting. Okay. And we'll go back to this one. Make that bigger again so we can see it. Okay. All right, so they did lie about that one. This one is a magnitude 2.0. Okay, this one here, they did report right. I get so mixed up here. Yeah, 329. Yeah, that's a 2.1. So anyways, yeah, I get all mixed up here because a lot of them, they don't report. Then up here, yeah, this would have been last night. We got a series of them, and they show up on multiple monitors. I'll show you the other monitor right there. This is the Norris Geyser Basin monitor, and they also show up there. All right, so I lined them up side by side. This is the borehole 207. You can see multiple earthquakes right here that they're not reporting, and they're also over here on the other one. And you can see all the one, oh, I don't know if you can see it or not, because there's so much activity. But there's multiple earthquakes that they're not reporting. Surprise, surprise. So this is a monitor here for the lake itself. This here is Little West Thumb, and this is Lake Butte. And I've talked about these a lot. All right, so here's Little West Thumb. Let me make that a little bigger. And this is also Yellowstone Lake, but this was created, probably about 160 to 150,000 years ago from an eruption. Yeah, they consider this a smaller little version, a caldera there. So the monitor for Little West Thumb is over here, and the monitor for Lake Butte is up over here on the right, right there. So this is the area where they have the crack, where a dike intrusion of rhyolite, which is a highly explosive, most explosive magma you can have. And we have three areas of hydrothermal vents. This canyon is the deepest part of the lake. It's 190 feet deep. And the water temperature down here is around 340 to 350 degrees. So here we have the two monitors, Little West Thumb on the left, Lake Butte on the right. And you see we got blobs. That's their actual scientific term, blobs of magma that was coming in the line of melt. Rocks do not all melt at the same temperature. So we got the heat coming up, and there's a layer here where there's pockets of melted rock. And you can see the earthquakes here. That there was an incident here. There you go. All right, let me go back right there at 6:44, where we had magma come in, and it got so strong that it popped the rock, broke the rock like glass, got really loud, and you can see how the magma came up at 6:44 in about 45 seconds. And if we look at the other monitor, Lake Butte, you can see the same time frame where that heated water. Yeah, let's look at the earthquake signature there. And we'll go there. We got another little incident here. Let me close this. It'll be bigger. All right. Let me close that. And open that. More blobs of magma coming in. Looks like a mixture of harmonic and volcanic tremors. And then this is what it was showing when I pulled the files earlier. Alright. Right there. I'll close that. Got a little earthquake there. Close that out. And we'll go up to this other incident. See if I can find it right there. Okay. At 23:51, just before midnight universal time. Yeah, that's much hotter than what came up here. That was much hotter. Let's see if I find it again. There it is. At least it looks hotter. Try and get the time for Lake Butte. There it is, right there. Up behind it, you can see the line of melt there, and the line of melt here. So, anyways, that's it for today. More of the same, not reporting the earthquakes. Yeah, a lot of earthquakes. On the weekends, I go home. There's no one there monitoring the different monitors. And then they come in on Monday, and once in a while they'll report what happened over the weekend, but generally they don't do that. Hopefully one day when Yellowstone does decide to go off, it has a large earthquake, but it probably won't. Outside of the caldera, it would have a larger earthquake than the inside of the caldera, because the caldera ground is so brittle from the uplift that's been going on. Hopefully it doesn't happen on a weekend because there's no one watching what's going on. Of course, we would all know when it blew. We would have probably no warning ahead of time because they don't work on the weekends. But anyways, that's all I have for you now. If you have any thoughts or comments or questions, please put those down below. Thank you for watching. Thank you for subscribing. Thank you very much for your support. If you wish to support my work, I'm also on Patreon. Please stay safe, and I'll talk to you later. God bless y'all. Bye.